Good morning, children. Welcome to this session of mathematics on the topic Lines and Angles, Chapter 5, Class 7. Please take out your books and notebooks, and now let us begin the topic.
Let us revise what we already know. The first one is line segment. So, line segment, it is the straightness which has two endpoints. Let us name these endpoints AB. So, line segment is the straightness which has two endpoints and has a definite length. This much. We can represent this as AB, and above that you make the line segment. Okay, so line segment is a straightness which has two fixed endpoints and has a definite length. So let us write the definition. It is the straightness that has two fixed endpoints and has definite length. Now, next in the topic is line. Now, what is this line? Let us draw this line segment having these two fixed endpoints. Now, if you extend this infinitely this side, and again you extend this infinitely this side, it becomes a line. So what do we say? That this line, it is the straightness which can be extended indefinitely in both the directions, this direction and this direction, and has no fixed endpoints. We can represent this as line AB. Line AB means you write AB and put the symbol of line here. Okay. We can also represent line using small letter of English alphabet. That is, we can draw a line like this and represent it with the small letter L. Okay, so how do we define line? Line, it is the straightness that can be extended indefinitely in both the directions and has no fixed endpoints. Got it? Third in the list is ray. Now, again you draw this line segment, it has two fixed points. Now you extend and name it AB. Okay, now you extend it from this side, that is in one direction only. When it is fixed and it extends in one direction only, so this is called a ray. We can represent this as ray AB. You write AB and put the symbol of ray. Okay, so we define ray as, it is the straightness that can be extended indefinitely in one direction only and the other end is fixed. Okay. Now coming to angles. What is an angle? This is one ray. Let us name it OA. And this is another ray. Let us name it OB. So what is angle? Two rays. These are two rays meeting at a common endpoint forms an angle. Symbol to denote angle is this. We write angle AOB. See here. Now, this center one, this is the vertex of the angle. And see this one, OB. This is one arm. And this is OA. This is another arm. So, if you are given angle PQR. So here Q is the vertex and QR and QP are the two arms of the angle. So we define angle as two rays meeting at a common endpoint forms an angle. Now we will see the classification of angles. Stop.
Go.
The first one is right angle. Right angle, the measure of this angle is 90 degree. I'll show you this with the help of mathematics. See like this. This is one arm of the angle and this is the second arm of the angle. So the angle formed between these two rays, this is the right angle. Okay. Second is the straight angle. The measure of this angle is 180 degrees. Now I'll show you with the matchstick. See, this is one ray and this is the second ray. So the angle formed between these two rays, this is the straight angle. Got it? We draw straight angle like this. Here I forgot to draw the right angle. You see here, it is like this. Okay. Now third one is acute angle. The measure of this angle is less than 90 degree. What it actually means, all the angles which are less than 90 degree are acute angles. Let us see this with the help of this matchstick. See here, this is 90 degree. Okay, now less than this is, say, this one. This is again acute angle. Again you move like this, it is an acute angle. Again you move like this, it is again an acute angle. You keep on moving and the angles which are less than 90 degree, they are all acute angles. Got it? Now, next in the list is obtuse angle. The measure of this angle is more than 90 degree but less than 180 degree. Let us see again this with the help of matchstick. See here, this is our 90 degree and this is our 180 degree. So obtuse angle lies between these two angles. Let us see here like this. See, this is 90 degree. You extend the angle like this. This becomes an obtuse angle. Again you further increase the angle. Again you keep on you increasing the angle like this, like this, like this, and you get obtuse angles. So all the angles between 90 degree and 180 degree, they are all obtuse angles. See here, obtuse angle. Got it, children? So only these angles are required in this chapter. So this is all about the revision which we should know before starting the topic. Now we will start related angles, which is a new topic for class 7. Let us start the related angles. First in the list of related angles is complementary angles. Now we need to understand what are complementary angles. Okay. Suppose this angle is 60 degrees and say this angle is 30 degrees. When we add these two angles, that is 60 degree plus 30 degree, we get 90 degree. So we define complementary angles as if the sum of two angles is 90 degree, they are called complementary angles. Okay. Also, each angle is the complement of other angle. What does this mean? Means 60 degree is the complement of 30 degree, meaning 90 degree minus 30 degree is equal to 60 degree. 30 degree is the complement of 60 degree, meaning 90 degree minus 60 degree is 30 degree. Understood? So now we'll start the questions related to this. Take out, think, discuss and write page number 95 NCERT book. First question is, can two acute angles be complementary to each other? Okay, two acute angles complementary to each other. We can take two acute angles. Let us take first angle is say 50 degree. Second angle is equal to 40 degree. So their sum 50 degree plus 40 degree, that is equal to 90 degree. So we say that two acute angles are complementary to each other. Two acute angles are complementary to each other. See here the questions. If it would have been, can two acute angles be always complementary? Word always here we don't have, but if it would have been always, then the answer is not correct, because if we take 70 degree and another we take 40 degree. Okay, both are acute angles. Find their sum. It is 70 plus 40 makes 110. So 110 is not 90. It is more than 90. So in this case, two acute angles are not complementary. Since it has given that two acute angles be complementary to each other, means it's optional. It may be, it may not be. That is why we have said that two acute angles are complementary to each other. Did you get my point? Okay, next, second. Second in the list is, can two obtuse angles be complementary to each other? So let us assume, again, let the first angle, let us take it 100 degree. Second angle, let us take 110 degree. Take out their sum. This is 100 degree plus 110 degree. It is 210 degree. So which is more than 90 degree. So we say that two obtuse angles cannot be complementary to each other. Okay, now the third part. Can two right angles be complementary to each other? Again, let us assume. Here, first angle is equal to 90 degree. Second angle equal to 90 degree. Their sum 90 degree plus 90 degree, which is equal to 180 degree. Again, this is more than 90 degree. So what do we say? We conclude that two right angles are not complementary to each other. Understood, children? Now let us come to try these, page 95, and start with question number 1. What is question number 1? Which pairs of following angles are complementary? Okay, so now see, these angles I have already drawn. So we have to find out whether these angles are complementary or not. Let us start with the first case. First angle is 70 degree. Second angle is 20 degree. Add up these two, it is 90 degree. So they are complementary. Okay, now see here, first angle is 75 degree, second angle is 25 degree. We add these two, we get 100 degree, which is more than 90 degree. So we say they are not complementary. Understood? Now see the third case. This I'll already discuss. I'll not write anything. See here, 48 degree and 52 degree. You add up 48 and 52, you get 100. 100 is more than 90 degree, so you say that these pairs of angles are not complementary. Okay, now here you see this angle is 35 degree, this is 55 degree. You find the sum, when you add it, you get 90 degree. So you say that these pairs of angles are complementary. Got it? Go. Question 2 is, what is the measure of the complement of each of the following angles? Now, if we have to find the complement of a given angle, what do we do? We subtract the given angle from 90 degree. That is, complement of 45 degree is 45 degree only, since 90 degree minus 45 degree is 45 degree. Okay, next here, complement of 65 degree is 25 degree. Since 90 degree minus 65 degree is 25 degree. Next two parts you will do on your own. See, this is 41 degree. You have to find out the complement. This is 41 degree. You have to find out the complement of this. So what you will do? Complement of 41 degree is 90 minus 41. Now you subtract 90 minus 41 and see what answer you get. That will be the complement. Again, then next is 54 degree. The complement of 54 degree will be what? 90 minus 54 degree. You subtract these two and get the answer. Whatever is the answer is its complement. Now next question is, I have written this question already. The difference in the measures of two complementary angles is 12 degree. We have to find the measures of the angles. Before starting this question, I'll give you a small example. What does this question actually mean? See here, it is given that we are having two complementary angles. And when we take the difference of these two complementary angles, the difference is 12. First, let us take a very small example and understand. If we take that two complementary angles as 50 and 40, their difference is 10. Okay. So here we know everything. Means we know two complementary angles and here we know difference also 10. But in our question, we don't know these angles. Okay, only we know the difference and we have to find these two angles. Now our smaller angle is this 40 degree. So 40 degree is the smaller angle. If we have to find out this bigger angle, what are we doing? We are adding this smaller angle with 10. 40 plus 10 is 50. So our bigger angle will be 40 plus 10. Okay. Now we don't know these angles. Suppose we don't know these angles and we assume that this angle is X. So we will write, let the smaller angle be X. And how do we get the bigger angle? This plus 10. So our bigger angle will be X plus 10. Got it? Now we'll go to the question. Now you see here. The difference in the measures of two complementary angles is 12 degree. We have to find the measure of the angles. Here we will assume, let the smaller angle be X. Then bigger angle is equal to X plus 12. Now it is said that they are complementary. Since they are complementary, so X plus 12 is equal to 90 degree. The sum of these two angles is 90 degree. Now X is how many times? 2 times. So we can write this as 2X plus 12, which is equal to 90 degree. Now we have to find the value of X. So we have to remove this 12 from here. So what do? We subtract 12 from both sides. That is 2X plus 12 minus 12 equal to 90 minus 12. So 2x plus 0 is equal to 90 minus 12 is what? 10 minus 2 is 8. 8 minus 1 is 7, 78. So we have 2x is equal to 78. Now we have to find the value of x. So we need to remove this 2 from here. So what do? We divide both sides by 2. So 2x upon 2 is equal to 78 upon 2. This 2 and 2 gets divided. Now when you divide this, this is what? 2, 3's are 6, 1 remainder and 2 9's are 18. So what do we get? X is equal to 39 degree. Now you have got your smaller angle, X as 39 degree. So your bigger angle, this is smaller angle, is 39 degree. So bigger angle is equal to what here? X plus 12. So this is 39 plus 12. 9 and 2 is 11, carry 1. 3 and 1, 4 and 1, 5. So the bigger angle is 51 degrees. So now you have calculated both the angles. The angles are 51 degree and 39 degree. You find the difference and see 51 minus 39, how much it comes? It will come 12 only. So your answer is correct. Got it? So children, this question completes our this session. Okay. Please go through the concept again. Try to do the questions on your own. If you have any doubts,
you may reach out to me on WhatsApp call or message. Okay? Take care. Have a good day. God bless you all.